Okay, the recording, yes. Okay, so today we are learning on chapter 5, which is called linear momentum. So linear momentum, we've heard of the word momentum before, which was in chapter 2. We talked about law of inertia, and we said that the way that we can quantify inertia is through momentum, right? And law of inertia states that an object continues in its motion unless acted on by a force. However, the law of inertia doesn't tell us how much is a big inertia or how small is a big inertia. So momentum tells us how to quantify that inertia. So for chapter 5, we are learning about linear momentum. And for this chapter, we have 3 subtopics, which are impulse and momentum, conservation of linear momentum, and also collision. So aim saya hari ni adalah to cover up until 5.2 lah, because it's fairly short and chapter 5 is not that hard compared to chapter 4 lah. It's quite easy. Okay, so the learning outcome that we are expecting out of this chapter is to know how to calculate impulse and momentum, to state the impulse theorem momentum, and also to state the conservation of linear momentum. In chapter 4, we learned about the conservation of energy. Here, we are learning about conservation of momentum ataupun linear momentum. And then we're going to solve problems related to collision, and we will discover that we have several types of collision. Okay. Oops. Letter conteng pula. Here is a graph of force versus time. And this is over time, the force increases and then goes down. But this area of the graph can also be approximated into a box like this, into a square lah, ataupun rectangle. So again, this is a force time graph. And this shows that over time, the force increases up to a maximum point and then it decreases. So ada macam peak lah. Dia peak. It has this peak where the force is the maximum at a certain time, right? So this is your T where it becomes maximum. And since this is a varying force, so it's quite hard to put it inside an equation. So what they did was, okay, let's approximate this area of the peak as the area of this rectangle. So they call this rectangle as the F average versus time, ataupun F average time. If we multiply this or we find out the area kita nak cari adalah ketinggian FAV ataupun F average dengan panjang T final minus T initial. So it gives you that area of the rectangle. And this gives us F average times with the length of time. And this one is actually equals to impulse. This graph, the area of this graph is actually called impulse. At the point, it is equal to impulse. So the equation for impulse is F average times with the duration of time that collision is happening. So let's take a look at Ian's video. Ian, Husnia and Afriza. Okay, stop sharing. I'm going to share this one. Kenapa tak suara? Sekejap. Ke saya mute kan korang? Is it? Was I muting you guys? Wah, malu. Tak apa.
Yes, that's depressing. We all know eggs cry when it's thrown from balcony.
So, Ian is saying that's depressing. Okay.
Yikes, that's depressing. We all know eggs cry when it's thrown from a balcony. Have you ever wondered why? What would happen if that was a human? Is there a way to prevent it? All these questions shall be answered in just a second. If a human gets thrown on the balcony, they will die, or they will get seriously injured. The reason why that egg cries and why we get injured can be explained by impulse force related to the concept of momentum and primarily based on Newton's second law. What is impulse force? And Newton's second law, you ask? I will leave the explanation to the others.
Newton's second law of motion states that the change in momentum of an object divided by the elapsed time is equal to the constant net force acting on the object, and it can represent by this formula, where the net force, also known as the impulse force acting on the object, is F, the change in momentum is mv minus mu, and the t represents the time taken for the change in momentum to occur. As you can see from this equation, when the time taken for the change in momentum increase, the values of impulse force decrease, and vice versa. An example of impulse force that you probably have experienced before is when you dive into bed. Diving into bed doesn't hurt, but dive into the ground is terribly painful. Why? The bed is soft and eases you as you fall, extending the time taken for the change in momentum to occur, resulting in less impulse force being acted upon you. Less force means less pain. In the comparison, the ground will stop you immediately. This means that the time taken for the change in momentum to occur is really short, and it causes a large impulse force to act on you.
The egg broke was simply because it couldn't withstand the impulse force acting upon it. The answer to preventing the egg from cracking can be found in the bag example. Yes, the solution is quite simple. Give the egg a bag to jump into, or find a way to ease the falling objects when they hit the ground. This can be achieved by wrapping towels around the egg. The towels serve as padding for the egg, increasing the time taken for change in momentum to take place. Since the reasoning for why eggs crack are the exact same as to why we suffer injuries from not just falling but from collisions in general, the solution is the same too. When we fall or crash into objects, safety equipment such as helmets, knee pads, airbag, and landing mats serve as our towels, increasing the time and decreasing the impulse force.
So always remember to use proper equipment when exercising, because after all, our bodies are only as fragile as an egg. Thank you, Nukrisnia and Noor Ariza, for working on this video. And here is the credits.
Okay, so thank you for that. Let me start sharing this one. Tengok Apple pun terliur ke? Awal korang. So, Ian, Afriza, and Husnia was telling us that there is another equation that we need to figure out, which is mv minus mu, which is the change in momentum over time. And the greater the time taken for the impact to happen, the lower your force. But if it takes a shorter time for you to stop when you're colliding with something, and it takes a shorter time for you to stop, then the force would be, the impulse force would be high. So kita akan belajar pasal equation ni juga. But the first equation that we need to know is F average times with the duration of time is equal to impulse. Okay. Oh. So impulse is F times duration of time. It is defined as the product of average force delivered to the object normally in a very, very short time. When we're talking about collision, it usually happens instantaneously, and the time taken is usually in millisecond or even shorter than that. So impulse is a vector quantity. The equation is F times delta T. Delta T is not a vector quantity, but force is a vector quantity, so therefore impulse is a vector quantity. They don't have a dot product here. They don't have a cross product here. It's just regular multiplication. So this guy follows F. It follows that it is a vector quantity. So impulse is a vector quantity, and force is kilogram meter per second squared, and time is second. So we can cancel that out. It becomes minus one kilogram meter per second, or it becomes Newton second. Both are acceptable, both are SI units. So impulse has the SI unit of Newton second or kilogram meter per second, and it is a vector quantity. So we're going to see that it is the same as momentum. Let's see that. So here, the momentum has a common meaning that we have that we know from chapter 2 before. It is the tendency of a body to continue in its motion unless acted on by a force. Dia akan bergerak je unless there's a force acting on it. So in for physics definition, it is the quantity to measure the tendency to oppose the change of motion, or like what force is required to change that motion lah. Okay. So linear momentum of an object of a mass m moving with velocity v is given by p equals to mv. We've seen this equation before. So p is also a vector quantity. This is regular multiplication, mass and velocity. Velocity is a vector quantity. When you times it with a scalar quantity, it still becomes a vector quantity. So momentum denoted as p is a vector quantity. And the SI unit is kilogram. This is kilogram and this is meter per second squared. Just like impulse. Impulse was I equals to F delta T and F was Newton second or kilogram meter per second. Kilogram meter per second. I missed out the second. Kilogram meter per second. So sama eh. Macam mana dapat kilogram meter per second? Tadi saya dah cerita. So it's the same as momentum, right? So it is both are vector quantities. P and I are both vector quantities. Denoted by this topi ataupun the arrow on the top. Okay, whoops. And we have also learned that momentum, we can have the change in momentum either by the change in velocity or the change in mass. Hello. Kacau lah. Okay. So we know that we can have the change in momentum either by the change in velocity or the change in mass. I told you before, if you have this equation, it does not have any delta here, then your right-hand side also does not have delta. When you have a delta in your P, it means that you have a change in P. That change has to be represented on the right hand side as well. You just have to pick whether it's going to be the change in mass or whether it's going to be the change in velocity. Since you guys are not aliens, we're going to assume that the only change that we can have is velocity lah. Kalau bertukar-tukar mass, takut juga kan? So we're going to say that the change in velocity is what we're aiming for when we're talking about the change in momentum. However, for mathematically, it can be represented as the change in velocity, mass times the change in velocity, and plus with the velocity that is constant times with the change in mass. So the rate of change in momentum. Now, this is another thing. I don't remember if I told you guys before. When we're talking about rate, we are always trying to find with respect to time. So if I say, what is the rate of momentum? I'm going to say, what is the rate of momentum? It is actually P over T. What is the rate of force? F over T. What is the rate of, what else have we learned? What is the rate of energy? E over T. What is this? This is power, right? So when we're talking about rate, it always means over time. We're always trying to find that quantity over time. So here, the rate of change of momentum is delta P over delta T. And this, when we have that delta T over here, remember we started out with delta P equals to M delta V plus V delta M. Now, where on earth did we get the delta T? We got it because we want it. I wanted to know what is the rate. So I put that delta T here. So if I put it on my left-hand side, I need to have it on my right-hand side as well. So kita assume macam ni eh. Kita macam ni. P delta V, V delta M. So if I'm putting this delta T over here, this guy has to have delta T. So this is how they have, each has that delta T over here. Why do I need on both hand sides so I can cancel them out? Sebenarnya mathematically it still stands as delta P equals to, M delta V plus V delta M. So kena balance eh. When you have that delta on the left-hand side, you have the delta on the right-hand side. When you have T on the left-hand side, you also have T on the right-hand side. This is very, 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 very important. You need to know this. Okay? You will use this sampai bila-bila actually. Okay, next. So Newton's second law of motion states that the rate of change of momentum of an object is proportional to the force acting on the object. Remember, we started with the law of inertia, first law, which is the law of inertia. Second law is F equals to ma. And then we tied up the law of inertia to force somehow. So here they tell us again that delta P over delta T is actually equal to force, and force is equal to ma. So F, when we have this equation, we can, when we put this delta T next to the T, sorry, when we put this delta T next to the F, it looks like impulse. And impulse is equal to change in momentum. That is why they have the same SI unit. Therefore, impulse is actually the change in momentum. So you can, these two are interchangeable. You can say that change in momentum is F times delta T. You can say that I is equal to change in P. You can say that I is the change in, is M times delta V. So they are connected to each other. So you can equate them. So let's write down the equation that we have learned so far. It's kind of a lot. So we learned about impulse is F delta T. And we also learned that P is equal to MV, but we're not interested in this one. Delta P is equal to M delta V. And we know that delta P over what? Delta T is equal to F. And I want to just rearrange this. So this becomes delta T. So delta P is equal to F delta T, or is equal to I. And you can write this guy to be M delta V as well. So these, so you have like four. I is equal to delta P is equal to M delta V is equal to F delta T. But this is hard to remember. So I just typically remember it like this. This is easy. P equals to MV, or delta P equals to M delta V. And I remember this guy, and then I equate these two guys together. So this is my approach. You can choose whatever that works for you. Okay. So impulse is basically the change in momentum. What else? Okay, so we talked about that one. Okay, so we go on to our problem for momentum and impulse. So just the normal stuff, read, visualize, apply the impulse momentum theorem, substitute the known value, calculate, blah, 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 state your answer, do not forget units. Boring old stuff. Okay, so kita akan mulakan with this one, the problems eh. Saya lupa nak padam, sorry. Eh? So example 5.1, a tennis player receives a shot. So he is receiving menerima. Eh? Receiving a shot with the ball 0.06 kilogram traveling horizontally at 50 meter per second. So this is our tennis ball. This is your tennis ball. It's traveling towards you. You are receiving it, menerima. Eh? You are receiving it at 50 meter per second. And returns the shot with the ball. Korang tennis player pula hari ni. So you are returning that ball at 40 meter per second. Kenapa tak sama? In the opposite direction. Adakah bermaksud opponent korang lagi kuat? Who knows? So the mass of this ball is 0.06 kilogram. What is the impulse delivered to the ball by the racket? So let's do this. Impulse is I equals to F delta T. Or delta P is equal to M delta V. What equation should we use here for A? Which equation? Is it the first one, the second one? Okay, so kita ada check kat sini. P equals to MV, second one. Okay. Number two. Okay. Kasih is saying Ian is so much different since the last time I saw him. Kenapa lain? Kenapa Ian lagi tinggi ke? Dulu rendah ke? Okay. Lepas tu, we're going to use the second equation. Okay. Second equation. why would this work as impulse? Because I is basically delta V, delta P. So this would be M delta V lah. So you can use either, I mean, it works lah, it works because they are the same thing. So P equals to, so we're gonna use I equals to M delta V. When we're talking about delta, it means that we're talking about final minus initial. V final minus MV initial. Okay, so M in this case is our ball, so 0.06. No, let me factor this out. So I want my life to be easy. So V M times V minus V initial. So this would give you delta V. Okay, so kita tulis mass is 0.06. V final is, what is my V final here? For the ball, is it 50 or 40? What did you learn? It's 40. Okay, it's 40. So Haikal dengan Nazihah said it's 40. 40 is our V final. Our V initial is 50. So this would give me 0.06. It's hari tu saya terlepas jatuh ke lantai. Lepas tu dia macam bengong lepas tu. Oh no, tak boleh. Okay, korang kena kira. How much is it? Minus 0.6. Brainshot. So this is minus 10 times with 0.06. So you get minus 0.6, betul. So this would be 0.6, the unit would be Newton second or kilogram meter per second. So let's just use Newton second. Okay, that is the impulse. It's a negative. What does that mean? Impulse is a vector. What does that mean? So our 40 is positive. So we're saying 40 as our positive. And then we want to minus with V initial, which is 50. But 50 is in the opposite direction. So what do we do here? Shouldn't 50 be negative? I took negative. So it's 40 plus 50. Yes, so it's 40 plus 50. So remember, velocity is a vector. You need to be careful with the signs. So 40, if I'm going to say 40 is positive, our 50 is negative. So 40 is positive minus minus 50. So you would get 90 over here. Uh-huh. So I don't know. I still don't know what the answer is. So whatever this is, Newton second. 1500. Okay, thank you. Is it 50 dengan ni 90? What is the impulse delivered to the ball by the racket? Okay, so it was, it's 1500. What work does the ball do? So we're talking about work, chapter 4 here. What work is it? What work is going on here? Is it gravitational potential energy? Is it spring potential energy? 5.4. 5.4 apa ni? For this eh? Saya kena scam ke? Haikal scam saya eh? Kasih 1500 ni. Tu, okay, kinetic energy. Sekejap, is it 1500? Okay, Ian is saying 5.4. So tadi saya kena scam. 5.4 eh? Newton per second. Newton second. Okay. What work does the ball do? So we're talking about, tadi ada orang jawab tadi, saya tak perasan. Nazihah is saying kinetic energy. Okay, so kinetic energy eh. So what's the equation for kinetic energy? Eh, korang unmute lah. Penat lah saya nak tengok chat. Ke is equal to, malu sangat nak cakap ni. Kenapa entah? 1/2 mv squared, okay? But is this the equation that we want to use? Come on, guys. What is the equation that we need to use? What work does the ball do? So Ke is energy. It's not work. How do we make it into work? Ke is just energy. It's not work. Fs. So how do we calculate Fs here? Kifeli is saying we need to find Fs. Other approaches, ada lain tak? How do we find out work? We know that we have kinetic energy going on here. How do we convert energy to become work? Remember, it's just, it's a simple approach. Tak payah cari Fs pun. Dah lupa dah chapter 4 ni. Oh my god, baru je belajar. Chapter 4, come on guys. How do I convert Ke to become work? The work must be equal to the change of kinetic energy. Yes, thank you. Penting ni, Ke tak boleh jadi work tiba-tiba. Dia kena jadi change in Ke, baru boleh jadi work. Okay, this is work energy theorem, guys. Okay, so work energy theorem states that work, the net work done on an object is equal to the change in kinetic energy. Okay, kena ingat eh, benda ni penting tau. I am pretty sure it's going to come up in the exam. Kinetic work energy theorem ni macam famous gila. Kalau tak pakai, tak tahulah. Sebab macam selalunya orang kantoi yang. Janganlah kantoi yang, saya dah ajar banyak kali dah ni. Okay, so work is the change in kinetic energy. So Ke final minus Ke initial. And someone already gave us Ke, which is 1/2 mv final squared minus 1/2 mv. Oops, it's a W. Mv initial squared. Habis dah cerita, sebab saya malas nak kira calculator. Okay, kita letak values, kita letak values. So 0.06, V final is 50 squared minus 1/2, 0.06. And V initial is, V final is 40. So kita silap. Kita follow Haikal lah. Haikal tadi cakap 40. So 50 squared. Okay. So you will get negative energy, right? Because this is 40 squared minus with 50 squared. So you get something that is negative. Berapa entah? Tolong kira kan? This is the last problem now that we're going to do, I think. Is this it? I like that. Lepas ni apa? Oh, law of conservation. Ayah, malas ni. Saya malas dah mengajar. Okay, okay. So 0.06. Berapa jawapan dia? Oh my god, where's everyone? Okay. Hello, where did everyone go? Change of kinetic energy. Okay, so that is the last one. Eh, mana semua orang pergi ni? Senyap je. Hello, hello, hello. Is it my internet? Okay, dah di chat. Takut nak bagi. So, minus 27 eh? Okay. Minus 27. I kala trauma nak bagi jawapan eh? Okay. So, minus 27 joules. So, this is your... Betul lah. Okay. This is your work done on the object ataupun on the ball, tennis ball. And it is negative because it is losing energy. Kemana? It is losing as friction ke ataupun as heat or as vibration. So it's lost to the environment. Okay? So kita dah berapa ni? Okay, sikit lagi. Lepas kita stop. Lost energy and then... Okay, so we're talking about conservation of linear momentum. The total linear momentum in an isolated system is always conserved. I mentioned to you before, isolated system ni maksudnya when we're talking about a situation, we're assuming it's the best kind of situation. For example, I'm talking about the kinetic energy of a car. So we're saying that the velocity of the car is 30 initially, and then it's 40 for V. Contohnya, U is 30, V is 40. So this is my question, right? And I say that it is isolated, in an isolated system, meaning to say that it's not going to be affected by the traffic light. It's not going to be affected by the pedestrian. Tak ada orang datang kat kereta tu ketuk-ketuk ke apa ke. So meaning to say it's in the best ideal situation because it is sheltered from benda-benda yang mengganggu. So this is what we assume typically when we're talking about systems. Kita assume dia dalam isolated system, benda-benda lain tak kacau lah. Tak ada lalat kacau ke. When we're talking about impulse tadi, ada racket ke, kita tak fikir bola tu ada lekuk ke, benda-benda macam tu tak ada. So we're talking about an isolated system, almost ideal. Okay, so no external forces acting on the system and it's the best situation lah. Okay, so total linear momentum is always conserved in an isolated system. What is linear momentum again? P is equal to mv. So we need to conserve this guy. In chapter 4, we conserved energy. For this chapter, we are conserving momentum. So what is this? Okay. So if we are talking about the conservation of momentum, we can apply this in situations of two colliding objects or the explosion of objects into pieces. Contoh, if I'm talking about one ball is moving this way and the other ball is moving this way. This is ball number one and this is ball number two. And then they collide, and then diorang bergerak, I don't know, ke sini and ke sana kot, tak tahulah macam mana. But they collide and in this collision situation, the momentum of these balls are conserved. For example, ball number one has M1, V, we start with U1, and this guy has M2, U2. This is the momentum of ball number one. This is the momentum of ball number two. When they collide, the momentum needs to be conserved, which means that M1, V1, M2, V2 should be equal to the summation of these two guys. So M1, U1 plus M2, U2 equals to M1, V1 plus M2, V2. This is the conservation of the momentum. Kita tambah dia punya initial momentum, it should be equal to the final momentum. If I were to write this in its general form, the net momentum initial is equal to the net momentum final lah. Okay, so this is for collision. For explosion of objects into pieces, for example, ada tak example yang saya boleh bagi? Okay, so let's say we're talking about a slab of plastic. It's a slab. Slab tu macam apa? Macam calculator punya ni. Macam ni kan? Alamak. Okay. Nampak tak calculator punya? Okay. Tak nampak juga. Okay. Calculator punya ni kan? It looks like a slab. It's plastic. So imagine ada bullet. Kita tembak bullet to this back of the calculator. Just the back of the calculator. So dia akan berkecai kan? Dia akan berkecai. So if I'm shooting this bullet has M1, U1. This guy is not moving, so dia tak ada momentum lagi. So bila dia tembak benda alam ni, dia akan berkecai. So our equation would be M1, U1 plus 0. Benda ni tak moving, it's not moving, it's at rest. So it should be 0. U is equal to 0, U2. It should be equal to M1. V1 plus M2 V2. It should be equal to this. So dia berkecai and mass dia merata-rata kan. So each mass tu kena ada velocity yang tertentu where it satisfies this equation. So boleh kira kan benda ni boleh kira in an isolated system. Kita assume tak ada orang kacau. Benda lain tak kacau dia. So you can actually calculate that. So it's pretty interesting. All right. So the impulsive force on an object normally delivered in a very short time, thus the average force is large and causes a large effect. So we talked, Ian talked about this. Ian has Susnia and Afriza. So in everyday application, we can reduce the effect of impulsive force by increasing the time of contact. So when we have a pillow ataupun an airbag, when we collide, hopefully tak, when we are in an accident, kita punya inertia is so big. This was talked about Haikal in his video. Our inertia is so big that we need the seatbelt and also the airbag. Airbag untuk apa? Kalau kita nak terantuk pun, kita akan terantuk. Our head will stop at a later time. Maksudnya the time taken for our head to bang on something is more. When the time taken is more, the force acting on our head will be lower. That is why airbag is now a must in all cars. Kalau kereta lama, tak ada lah selalunya. Di kereta baru semua kena ada. Eh? And kalau airbag tu faulty, dia akan recall. Dia akan panggil balik, dia suruh pasang airbag baru. Ataupun dia baiki lah. And airbag is a must. Seatbelt dari dulu lagi dah wajib kan? Because it also extends the time before kita punya badan comes to a complete stop. When we come to a complete stop, we either kita akan deal with some type of force and we want that force to be small. So kita always nak panjangkan masa sebelum badan kita betul-betul stop. Okay? So this is why seatbelt and airbag is very, very important and dah wajib in all cars right now. So apa lagi saya nak cakap kat sini? Sama. Okay, types of collision, I'm gonna let Dr. Suzy cerita lah. Okay? So that is it from me. Oh, sedihnya. That is it from me for chapter 5 and for this semester. I hope I've done my best for you guys. I know I've done my best, but I hope you guys feel that I've done my best for you guys as well. Okay, I will always keep you in my heart. Apa lagi saya cerita? Ah, jangan nangis. Okay. So I'm always available eh korang. So don't be a stranger. Okay. Okay, I'm quite sad. Okay, let's stop sharing. Jom kita ambil gambar. Kenapa korang senyap? Unmute. Okay, so let's gallery. Thank you to all. Tapi kenapa ada orang punya terbalik? Macam Afgah punya betul. Lepas tu Husni. Okay, tadi terbalik. Sekarang nak terbalik dah.
Doktor?
Yeah.
Can you let me screen sharing?
Apa? Screen sharing?
Nanti boleh tak? Bagi saya. Dah bagi ya?
Dah bagi dah. Boleh tak?
Okay. Nak ambil gambar dulu ke? Ambil lah gambar dulu.
Okay. Jom kita ambil gambar. Alah, saya punya screen tak sama dengan korang. Tak apa eh. Okay. So part 1, 2, 3 tau. Tunggu sekejap. Okay, first page ada Haikal sampai Yanjui. Saya tak tahu urutan macam mana ni, tapi capture je semua page kan. Okay, 1, 2, smile. Okay, next one. Okay, 1, 2, where's my face? I'm not there. Bukan saya tak ada kat sini. The next page saya tak ada. Saya capture je lah, nanti saya stitch eh. Okay, one.
Doktor boleh ni kan pindahkan kalau doktor nak pindahkan.
Saya tak reti lah macam mana. Sekejap, saya cuba. Okay, cannot move. Okay, I am pin. Let me unpin myself. Okay. Boleh tak? Oh, boleh ya? Betul. Sekejap, saya cuba lagi. Tapi move to the next page. Okay. Jangan. Sorry lah tak pandai pakai Zoom. Okay, dah masuk. Okay. Next page, Amy tak on lah. Kenapa Amy tak ada? Amy. Calling Amy. Cheki awak jangan lah kata dengan sangat. Okay, saya ambil first page balik lah. Okay, 1, 2. Smile. Okay, save to desktop. Next page, Amy tak ada. Okay, tak apalah. 1, 2, to smile. Okay. Aimi, cepat on, cepat on. Awak boleh ke tak on? Awak punya ni je. Tak boleh kan? Tak boleh on ke?
Saya punya kamera tiba-tiba meragam, doktor. Sorry.
Oh, okay, okay. Aimi nak letak gambar Aimi dekat dalam tak? Dekat dalam your profile. Ini saya ada gambar. Macam Soh ni pun letak gambar je. Kenapa entah Soh tak on ni? Pendek Soh. Ah, ada pun. Dekat profile. Dekat profile awak. Boleh tak? Pergi dekat. Saya nak ajar orang Zoom pula lawak ni. Saya ajar bukan tu. Macam mana eh?
Nak tunjuk okay. Something boleh?
Masuk dah. Dah masuk dah. Sekejap eh. Kita ambil gambar Aimi sekejap. Okay, one. Okay. Okay. Dah lah Aimi kan introvert. Cik. Pernah tak? Aimi juga introvert. Okay. One, two, smile. Okay, second page. Dah. Okay, thank you guys.
Today. Eh, belum, belum.
Oh, okay.
Doktor, I kan nak tunjuk something.
Eh, saya nak tunjuk something.
Okay, tunjuklah.
Sekejap eh. Nampak tak?
Nampak, tapi saya nampak folder.
Ha ni, ni ada video sikit Farhan buat. Nampak tak video ni?
Nampak, tapi kecil. Besarkan. Eh, dia memang besar lah ke ni? Zoom tu. Ha. Amboi gambar saya.
Dengar tak suara?
Tak.
Kenapa? Tak dengar.
Memang tak ada suara ke apa?
Saya bagi awak jadi host lah. Kejap, saya bagi awak jadi host. Kenapa? Tapi kenapa korang ambil gambar saya? Ini gambar korang.
Mula pelik je. Ni Farhan buat bukan saya.
Thank you Farhan. Okay, saya dah buat share, share video punya suara.
Sini eh. Tak ada suara eh?
Oh, bila
tak ada suara kan?
Bila awak share tu, share. Oh, Farhan.
Dengar tak?
Saya dengar suara awak, video tak tahu.
Video tak dengar.
Nah.
Video dah start ke? Tak start pun?
Dia pause.
Hangat.
Is that Aika panik?
Dengar tak?
Dengar.
Okay, okay. Kita yang dengar. Ni yang kat tu tau, bukan kat tele. Huh? Okay. Ni tengah pause kan? Tengah pause kan?
Ya.
Okay, saya start eh. Semua, okay. Semua sedih eh. Ambil tisu.
Takutnya.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here but you're not, cause the drinks bring back.
Sekejap eh. Nampak kan? Semua nampak kan?
Nampak. Kenapa?
Okay. Sekarang tengah nama student digunakan kan?
Aha.
Call the memories of everything we've been through.
If Haikal is here. Okay, Haikal dengan Syakilah. Okay. Haikal warna pink eh. Sorry Haikal. So Syakil is blue. Terbalik tapi tak apa. Tak apa, aku cakap colour refers to a certain gender, right? Contohnya, tadi Ifah dia duduk dekat atas bangunan, dia nak baling Harden X kan. Tapi dia tak baling, dia satu fans. Contohnya, this is, nak cakap siapa? Nak cakap Haikal lah. This is Haikal. Haikal is flying.
Sorry, Haikal.
He's flying and then dia jatuh kat sini. Kesian Haikal. So as you can see here, mula-mula our particle ni dia berjalan macam ni. Semut lah kot, ni semut. Okay, semut dia mula daripada point A and dia berakhir di point B. Semut eh, semut. Mana boleh tak tahulah. Okay, I don't know, but gambar dia kasi tu macam kita kebal lah. Tu bayangkan kita kebal lah. I really don't know what it is. Oh, kita tebal kita punya ayam sini eh. Okay, it's fired with an initial velocity. Yang tak tahu. After week 9, your class will be, your physics lecturer will be Dr. Suzy. Everything gonna be alright. Gonna raise a glass and say, hey, here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the dreams bring back all the memories. Thank you, korang.
Lepas lepas tu, nampak tak yang ni? Nampak tak? Screen.
Nampak?
How you ni? Nampak tak, doktor?
Nampak, nampak.
Nampak tak for you? Ha, ni ni kita orang ada buat kata-kata tahir, kalau nak cakap memang tak sempat lah. Lepas tu nanti saya share lah kat doktor link ni. Ni doktor baca lah.
Baca sekarang ke nanti?
Pulang lah. Okay. Nanti saya bagi juga. Saya bagi dalam grup.
Dah lalang saya nangis ni, tengok je lah, jom.
Baca lah doktor nak baca mana.
Oh, kat sini ke tempat lain? Tak faham.
Ah, okay, okay. Sabar. Oh, so nanti saya bagi, nanti saya bagi. Saya bagi sang.
Okay.
Nah, sedih-sedih. Saya pun sedih.
Okay, bye korang.
Sekejap eh, saya bagi.
Dah habis ke belum? Ah, sedihnya.
dah saya ni lah. Saya tutup.
Dah lah, recorded. Ya Allah. Recorded kot.
Okay, tu je lah. Dari kami. Saya bagi personal ke dan group?
Bagi dan.
Saya bagi dan group lah.
Okay. Thank you korang.
Haikal, kata-kata terakhir.
Oh,
kata-kata
terakhir. Terima kasih. Saya nak ucapkan terima kasih sekalung penghargaan kepada Dr. Nadia Husaini sebab mengajar kami selama 9 minggu. Walaupun kadang tu ada lesu dia kan, senyap je doktor. Walaupun kadang doktor je buat kamera, kami tengok je. Macam doktor seorang je mengajar kan. Maaf lah sebab tu.
Jadi kelakar pula bila Haikal kasi speech. Okay, okay.
Lepas tu, saya dan kami semua sentiasa di belakang doktor mengharapkan kebahagiaan, kesejahteraan, dan saya harap doktor dalam keadaan sihat dan berjaya lah.
Thank you.
Dia tengoklah tablet tu saya dah bagi.
Okay.
Yang tak buat lagi, bagi buatlah.
Ada lagi orang tak buat ke? Ah, lagi sedih je tak ada lah. Okay. Thank you korang. It was so thank sweet. You. Thank you. I really enjoyed the video and your background. Tahu tak? The first time orang buat macam tu guys. Thank you so much. And I hope you guys berjaya whatever you choose to do. You don't have to become doctors, you don't have to become engineers. Just choose what you like to do, what you are passionate about. I will always support you to do it. I just want you guys to be happy in life, okay? So all the best. And I'll see you around. Kat saya kat UPM. Oh, yeah, lukis for doctor. Thank you. Bye korang.
Thank you,
doktor. Follow saya ke IG tau. Ataupun.
Thank you, doktor.
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 Thank you,
doktor. Thank you, doktor. Bye-bye. Thank you, doktor.
Bye, doktor.
Thank you
for everything, doktor. Bye-bye.
Bye.